Good afternoon. Tragic new details have emerged following the death of a 16-year-old girl in a car crash on the way to a Taylor Swift concert in Melbourne. As Eddie Meyer reports, the teenager's younger sister is now fighting for life.
It was meant to be a trip of a lifetime, months in the planning and finally coming true. Mika Pecarier, her mother and 10-year-old sister Freya were driving from the Gold Coast to Melbourne for Taylor Swift's Friday night concert. Joy turned to tragedy on the first leg of that journey. The family's car collided with a semi-trailer just 30 minutes from Dubbo in central western New South Wales. They're stopped for the night. 16-year-old Mika died at the scene.
Feels like Mika might just be staying at someone's house, and I think that it's really going to hit us further that when we get home, the reality of it, that she's not coming back.
10-year-old Freya was airlifted to Sydney's Westmead Children's Hospital, where she's fighting for her life in an induced coma. Her mother, who suffered minor injuries, now joined by other family members by her side. These girls could easily be termed super fans. After Melbourne, the family planned to drive to Sydney for another concert. Mika had even created a special playlist on her iPad of Taylor Swift music. It was the last thing she was listening to when the crash happened.
The parents of a 12-year-old boy killed while crossing a busy Melbourne intersection have said their world will never be the same. Kai Duclos was walking home from school on Friday when he was struck by a car in the city's southeast. He was airlifted to hospital but died a short time later. The driver stopped at the scene and is assisting police. A group of thugs armed with machetes, bats and hammers have left a man seriously injured during a daylight attack west of Melbourne. Gillian Lantouris reports.
Police were called to this Weirview McDonald's to find a young man bleeding out in the bushes behind me following a frenzied attack. Witnesses say a group of up to five masked men pulled up on Exford Road in a black sedan before chasing down a man in his 20s, stabbing him multiple times around 5 o'clock yesterday.
Machetes, hammers, knives and baseball bat.
The horrifying incident unfolding in front of young families who live in the area and some who were shopping at the nearby plaza.
Holy
Good Samaritans rushed to help the injured man.
We ended up wrapping a t-shirt around his arm and a strap around the top of his arm as it was quite severe.
He was taken to hospital in a serious condition with wounds to his back, head and arm. Police say this is a targeted attack. No arrests have been made. During the ordeal, the McDonald's here had to close for 3 hours while police investigated. Meanwhile, residents have told me crime is becoming far too common in this area, with some reconsidering living here.
Prime Minister Anthony Albanese insists he has full control of Australia's borders despite the arrival of around 40 asylum seekers in WA. Federal politics editor Charles Croucher reports.
This group of asylum seekers are in the hands of Border Force officials and likely on their way to Nauru after coming ashore in Australia in the northwestern part of Western Australia. They will be bound for a foreign country to be processed there. The government says their policy remains the same. It is the same Operation Sovereign Borders Border Force policy that has existed since the Abbott government that hasn't stopped the attacks.
So I think what people smugglers are working out is that this government is a weak government on national security. It's weak on border security, and they're now testing the Prime Minister.
We're very confident that Operation Sovereign Borders remains in place. We are implementing the policies that we said we would.
This is all about the makings of the government and the perception that people smugglers are able to sell.
Yesterday, Border Force officials said that mixed messaging or division politically can actually play into the hands of people smuggling operations. But in such a charged political environment, that call will likely fall on deaf ears.
Supporters of Alexei Navalny claim his body is being hidden in a cover-up as his mother is turned away from the prison where he died. Europe correspondent Edward Godfrey has today's developments.
A day after Alexei Navalny died, his mother has travelled to the remote penal colony
where he'd been detained. Supported by a lawyer, she arrived at the highest security prison in the Arctic Circle, nearly 2,000 kilometres from Moscow. She had to wait 2 hours before she was told her son's body had been taken away by investigators, eventually leaving with just a note. A family spokesperson saying the 47-year-old father of two died at 2:17 in the afternoon, adding, "Alexei was killed. We demand the release of his body immediately." Navalny supporters claim his body is being hidden. A close ally later tweeting they'd been told the Russian opposition leader died of sudden death syndrome. President Vladimir Putin always refused to utter Navalny's name. He's given a televised address with no mention of his death. In Munich, there was a minute's silence for him by ministers gathered for a G7 meeting. In Russia, many are mourning for the man they say was a fierce fighter for change. Tributes laid at makeshift memorials, despite being warned not to. More than 340 people arrested across the country. Now, even the simple act of laying a flower is considered a brave act.
Thousands of Sydney school students have been told to stay home as the city's asbestos contamination crisis grows. Mark Burrows has more.
The EPA has announced another two schools have joined the list of sites that have tested positive to bonded asbestos that's found in garden mulch. The first school is the Penrith Christian College, which is at Orchard Hills. The second school is St Luke's Catholic College at Marsden Park. That school will remain closed for at least a week because of the quantity, some 30 cubic metres of mulch, that has to be removed around the site. It now means there are four schools that have tested positive to asbestos. They include Alambic Public School at Alambie Heights, Liverpool West Public School at Liverpool, and the school at Penrith and St Luke's College. There are now 34 sites in and around Sydney that have tested positive. Tests are also underway on mulch found around the Sutherland Hospital, but that continues to operate as normal. And mulch that was found near the Sydney Olympic Park site on a median strip was finally cleared last night, and that means the Taylor Swift concert will go ahead as normal later this week.
Chinese New Year celebrations have been cut short in South Melbourne after a fire at a cultural temple. The blaze broke out at Si Yup Temple around 9 o'clock last night, damaging the worshipping hall inside the heritage-listed site.
When I saw the front door, I burst into tears, actually, involuntarily, because this place is pretty close to my heart.
Arson Chemists is inspecting the site, but the community believe the blaze was accidental.